Hello everyone, this is Freya and welcome to a new episode of Freya's Herbs. In this episode, we are going to talk about aloe vera. Is one of the oldest medicinal plants in history. It is not a cactus, though. It belongs to the lily family, a relative of onion and garlic. For millennia, the humble aloe vera has been celebrated for its medicinal qualities. Both the leaf juice and the latex, the sticky yellow residue right under the skin of the leaf of the aloe vera, can be used to enhance, beautify, and heal the human body. Aloe is one of those herbs that my grandma used to say is good for everything. Folk medicinal uses for aloe. There are more than 75 active components that have been identified in this plant. These active components include vitamins, minerals, enzymes, saccharides, amino acids, and antioxidants. It's used in diabetes, skin problems, hair conditions, constipation. It's a very simple plant to harvest for gel and juice. You will need a mature plant that's at least a few years old. This ensures a higher concentration of the active ingredients. Aloe has constituents that help in binding moisture to the skin. It helps critically in providing moisture to the delicate skin under your eyes. Skin can become dry and irritated due to any reason, and using aloe helps return moisture back into the skin. It also makes the skin more elastic and less wrinkled. Aloe is one of those blessings from nature that serves various medicinal and healing properties. Household uses for aloe. The healing properties in aloe can help with nearly any hair issue. From reducing frizz to livening up dry, dull hair, from eradicating dandruff to stimulating speedy hair growth, aloe can do it all. Magical uses for aloe. Aloe was used to ward off evil spirits. The magical uses of the plant all spin around protection, luck, water magic, lunar magic. People would keep this plant in their kitchen to prevent kitchen accidents. The plant can be used as a substitute for the moon in some spells pertaining to the moon. Hung in the home, it also attracts luck and prosperity to the household. Plant an aloe on the grave of a loved one to bring peace. Aloe is thought to relieve loneliness. It's used for drawing love as well, primarily by burning the plant during full moons. It's said this will bring a lover by the new moon. Dry the leaves first. There are many shamanic uses for aloe. It is used for protection, good luck, cleansing, and spiritual baths. I think aloe is really good if you have been through a major transition in your life, like moving into a new home, for example. It helps calm the mood when you are left feeling nostalgic and lost. It makes you feel at peace with your surroundings. Shamanic uses for aloe. The frequency vibration that aloe has is mystical. The main use of aloe is to recalibrate the body's frequency system. Mystics use aloe to turn turn off all the negative signals within the body. Several scholars agree on the fact that the organic germanium within the aloe provides the necessary instructions and the building blocks for the immunity system to recalibrate itself and cancel out the negative vibration. This plant truly represents the blood of the gods. Aloe is associated with feminine energy, the element of water, the moon, the astrological sign of Cancer. It is, in my opinion, sacred to Freya, and as a part of Freya's cult, bitter aloes can be used in binding spells. As an offering to Freya, I will recommend to use aloe in conjunction with the rune Lagus, since this is the rune representative of the tides and water. Thank you so very much for watching this video. Thanks for spending some of your time here with me today. It's been truly appreciated, and I'll see you all in my next video. Tack så mycket. Hej då! Trees, a dancing while the spring's still here. They don't make haste cause they know what's coming. We try to wash away our broken years, but it's so hard in the cold summer. Your smile in the morning.